Hello friends, welcome to Easy Code for All. Today we will see how to generate Java bean or pojo classes from XML or JSON. So there are three utilities related to this. One is XML to pojo, another is XML to Java beans, and JSON to pojo. All are kind of similar, but there are differences. All of them generate the Java bean class or Java pojo classes along with some utility and other classes. So I'll go through all of them one by one and explain which tool can be used in which situation. So XML to pojo, this is the simplest one. Here what it does, it convert one XML document to Java bean classes, or rather Java bean classes or pojo classes can be generated from XML. Let's visit it. If I click it, you can see if I give a XML, I can generate corresponding Java bean classes like XML to bean converter or XML to pojo converter. Here what it does, it generates Java bean classes based on this XML, but in that bean classes all the class variable or rather instance variable type will be string. So it will generate Java class, for it will generate the Java code to describe the bean classes based on this XML, and in that bean classes all the instance variable will be string. Along with that, in the bean classes you can mention it, like whether you want to generate the toString method or not, whether you want to add JACB annotation or not, whether you want to add JSON property annotation or not actually. So these annotations will helpful if you would like to use your bean classes in your application, where you need to read the data from XML and populate to a Java bean, or if you need to read the data from the JSON and need to set it into Java bean. In those situations, these annotations will be useful. So you can opt for it, or you can uncheck it if you do not want to need it. So here you can control how your bean classes will look like. Second thing is that you can give your project package name, like under which package you want to generate the bean classes. And lastly, this bean class postfix, it's a bean. Like if you want to generate the Java classes with the name author bean, books bean, book bean, in that case you can put it here. Or if you do not want to generate the Java classes with the postfix bean, so you can delete it. Just you will get an idea if you generate the code. So let's go ahead and generate the code. If I hit it, it will generate the code. Okay. Now I can download the code actually. Let's download it. Okay. Now I'll unzip and I'll show to you. After unzip, I got this folder. In this folder, all the generated Java classes are there. If you remember, it has generated the Java file names with bean, actually author bean, because on that input the bean word was there as a postfix. Along with that, it has generated all the bean classes, and if you look any of the bean classes here, you can see it has generated annotation for each of the getter method. So this annotation can be useful in your project if you are dealing with JSON or XML. and if you do not want, you can you do not need to check those check boxes. Another point is that here all the variable, their data type is a string, okay, and for sub, like sub child element, you will have a separate bin classes and you can have the association with the parent class, okay, but that XML attributes that will appear as a instance variable in the bin classes, and their data type will be string. Their data type will be string. That is one of the important factor are here actually, and it will generate setter getter method, and it will generate the two strings method also. So in the two strings method, the two string method, it uses like object mapper to convert the object to JSON string, and it can log the JSON string. So if your log level is debug enabled, then only it will log it, otherwise it will not log it actually. And in the generated code, it uses log4j. It uses log4j. So it adds the code to log the to log the string representation of the your bean class actually. So it uses log4j. Okay, if you do not want to use it, you can remove it, but by default it uses log4j because maximum project uses log4j. So this is the bean classes. It will be generating all the bean classes. Okay, now I along with the bean classes, it generates another two util class. Let me go through those. So along with the bean classes, it gives you three util class. One is XML util, another is bean object util, another is bean to XML util. So what this does, it is a sample XML util file which you can use it. It has a XML utility method, so that you can use it. It's a sample XML util file. You can directly use it. Otherwise, if you have your own XML util, you can use that also. But I'd be suggesting compare with your XML util, and if some methods are not matching, you take this method, copy this method, and add it into your XML util, or you can directly use this XML util file. Next, we'll go to the other two bean classes. So these two bean classes is kind of important. This is XML to bean. Like this class generates the code, like which can be used to read the XML and populates its value to a bean object. If I open it, you can come to know. So what it does mainly, it convert XML to bean object. Like if you have any XML file or XML document, you can use this code to read that XML document and create a bean object and set all the values to the bean object and return to you. So this method can be useful for you if you need to read the data from XML and get that data in a Java object. So you can use this method to convert a XML XML document or XML content to a Java bean object. So this is a sample code. It's a code, it generates it. It can be useful to read the XML file, set that XML data into Java object and return that object. Similarly, we have one more util file. Let's go there. This util file, it convert a Java bean object to XML document. Like if you want to save your bean state, bean content to a XML file, this util file can be used actually. If you look into that, you can convert a bean object to XML. So this method can be used to convert a bin object to XML. So it is creating an XML document and taking the value from the bin object and setting into the XML document and returning it actually. So these two util file, it will be useful to you if you are dealing with XML, if you are reading the data from XML, or if you want to shape the bin content or bin state into the XML file. So these two util file can be used. So this tool pretty simple and straightforward, generates the Java bin classes or POJO classes and three util file. One is XML util for XML processing, another two util file. One is to read the data from XML and set it into the Java bin object. Another is take the value from the Java bin object and set into a XML document. So this is about the XML to bin utility or XML to POJO utility. Let's go to the other utility or tools that are available. So these two utility also can be used to generate POJO or Java bin classes from XML or JSON. I'll talk about these two utility in the next video. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please do use EasyCodeForAll.com to generate your project code.